I recently had the opportunity to attend a dig workshop with the Whiteside Museum in Seymour, Texas. The town of Seymour sits in a Permian-era rock exposure known as the Red Beds. Located just outside of town is the world-famous Craddock bone bed, source of most of the Dimetrodon fossils you see in museums today. After a brief explanation and history of the site, we got our eyes tuned in for the local fossils by surface collecting, before moving into the active quarry.
Great. So this one, see the hole that runs down through the middle? So that's a hypodermic canal, and this is from the freshwater shark, Orthocanthus. And so the sharks had a head spine on the back of their skulls, and it was full of venom. And so that venom canal would have been full of poison, essentially. And so if a Dimetrodon tried to bite the back of the skull, he would get a mouthful of venom. And so that's a part of that shark's head spine, freshwater shark's head spine. So yeah, when you see that poison canal down the middle, that tells you it's a shark head spine. Neat.
I've never seen that before.
Yeah. So stingrays today, you know, have one on their tails. They don't have them on their heads. They have them on their tails. Same idea. Just.
That's what you just picked.
Yeah, that was it.
Yeah. So.
Good tell.
It's fossilized shark cartilage. So. Oh, it's all comprised of little calcite crystals that make cartilage. Do you have access to a microscope at all?
I do.
So when you get this one home, look under the scope, and you can kind of see it here, the little dots.
Okay.
Each one of those dots is a cartilage, individual cartilage crystal, which is essentially a hexagonal calcite.
Okay.
And that's what cartilage is comprised of, but this will be fun for you to see under the microscope.
Cool.
Oh, this is a little Dimetrodon tail vertebra. Very, very end of the tail. It's got some caliche on it, but... underneath of it, you'd see the bone. But yeah, it's a Dimetrodon tail vertebra. Excellent. So this guy is amphibian. So this one is a labyrinthodont. So the labyrinthodont means maze tooth, and it has a lot of little striations on it, little lines running down the top, and that tells you it's an amphibian. Probably a diplocallis or eriops, one of the two.
Okay.
And this one. So that one's got part of the groove running down the middle. So it's probably a Dimetrodon fin spine. It's probably at the very tip of it, very end of it. It's starting to lose the figure eight, but it's still got a little bit of the canal. So it's Dimetrodon tailbone.
Cool. Thank you.
That's really nice. Look at that tip.
Yeah,
so intact.
That is beautiful.
That is wonderful.
Yeah, what's that tooth from?
Thank you.
betcha. Dang, so it does look like there's a bite mark there. Let's keep going into there. That's hilarious. So either it's been bitten off completely, happens, or it's shifted and you might pick it up again somewhere in here. So we'll just keep exploring and see if you pick it up again. But it's still a freaking spectacular piece. But yeah, that's a big chew mark right on the top there. But I bet you you'll see something else in there.
That's a sail bone?
Yeah, one of the fin spines, the Dimetrodon fin spines.